Hello together to another video tutorial. My name is Pascal Dresselhaus and I'm a TwinCAT product manager. Today I like to show you how to work with network templates for an easy engineering in TwinCAT Analytics. For this I have prepared a TwinCAT Analytics project on my screen here, and there's a small configuration for an analysis of a tool of a milling machine. And in this milling machine we have a tool torrent, and so as you can see here in target browser where we get all the data, there are three different tools, and we like to analyze now all of them at the same time, and therefore it is a bit handwork to do all the same configuration steps here for all three tools. Therefore, it gives a solution in TwinCAT Analytics, and this solution is called Network Templates. And the content of this video tutorial is how to deal with these kind of templates. Therefore, you have to know the network template means here network. TwinCAT Analytics is organized in networks, so you can have networks at the same level, so multiple in parallel. But you can have also hierarchical constructions like network and network, like here. So the deepest network we have is this tool monitoring network, and this should be in the end or a template to analyze all the three different tools in our tool torrent of the milling machine. How to proceed? First of all, we have to work here with this network header. You can see this header also in the upper network here, and that is this one again, but we go in here first, and so we can implement a new network input here to the header of the network. We can name this, for example, here tool in use, because we like to analyze here how often it is used and if it is in use, yes or no, and so on. And now it is mapped from here to here, as you can see in the mark here. So the yellow mark, this is how it is mapped. Then for this, for the min-max average calculation of the tool temperature, we add another network input. Call it tool temperature, and then also this is mapped here to the header. For the next one we do not need that, because here we have an analysis chain, so we took the min-max average value here as an input for the threshold classifier, and here we have the different threshold levels and then the results. This is fine for us. There's no additional input from outside. And here we have a section timer, which observe different temperature areas in this case here, how long we are in which area with our tool. And of course, this is the same temperature as here. And so we can go here and took the network inputs here, and this is already existing, and so it is mapped now to the same input as you can see here with the yellow mark. And so we are ready now with the inputs. We can do the same for the parameters. I keep it easy, so I will just link here the threshold classifier parameters for warning and alert level. And then we can define here for the outputs what is the most important thing. So I think is on or not, this is important. How often maybe, it's the same. Then we have an interest, for example, in the maximum value and also in the time where it was maximum, the temperature. Then we take here the classifier, if the average is fine or not of the temperature. And here from the section timer, we take the complete output. We can do this here with some sub-elements because there are different sections, or we can take the complete one. We take the complete one. Then we have here a small inline histogram about the different areas we have defined here in the parameters. And so our network template more or less is ready. To proceed, we go here, make a right click, go to the context menu and say save as template. Then we see what is inside happen in the template, or as closed template. Then we get just the header here as one single block, as you know it from all the other base algorithm in TwinCAT Analytics. But I like to show you a special feature. As far as you know, you can add for your configuration automatically by one click here and reference scope project. This scope configuration is related to the configuration you have did here in the analytics editor. So you see here, for example, a YT chart with the name tool monitoring. We have an axis with a large real and Boolean, because we have two different kind of data types here, and we have the threshold classifier as a member of the configuration with dynamic styles and scope view with warning level and alert level, so that we change the color of this variable. But I like to individualize this now, so I don't like to see that, for example, so I delete it. So please delete, yes. Then for both channels here, I go to the properties. I like to increase the line width to 4, maybe also the mark size if I like. I can change here the line color. So I like to have a temperature always as in green color, for example. And also nice is if I go back to the network here, I can take now the histogram, the inline histogram via drag drop and put it here to the reference scope, and then he adds me automatically an array bar chart, and also here I can change now the color. And then I define, that's fine for me, okay, that's good. So I can go back here to my network and say again save, and then it is there's suddenly a third option, configure template, and I choose that one. And as you can see now, he put together the configuration of analytics and the scope configuration, which is related then to this network. I defined this as closed network, so you see that also nice in the animation that this blocks will not visible anymore. So I have later on just the header of this tool monitoring block. And this is combined then with this complete scope configuration and is stored in a path of my engineering system. And so I can also share this template later on with other colleagues from my service team or from my application guys for machine commissioning, whatever. That just one has to think about the best analysis of a tool in this case. I save this, and then we will see in the toolbox. We go back to the toolbox, we'll scroll down here, and then we see under templates, tool monitoring. This is a new template now, which I can take as a single block for my configuration. And to present this, I will delete here some things first. So I delete here my reference scope and also the complete internal network here, tool monitoring. I do not need that anymore. And so I have just the root network here. And then I can take this new template via drag drop. But now I press the control key as well. And then I see a new window. I can say, okay, I like to provide some new default values here for my thresholds, 45 and 55. and I need 3 instances of it. And now Analytics adds me very fast 3 instances, and now I can go ahead with my tools here. Tool 1 in use, tool 2 in use, tool 3 in use, and the same for the temperatures, temperature 1, temperature 2, and temperature 3. And then I can start my recording. Now I get the data from my small simulation controller here with the analytics logger via MQTT, and the same is possible for ADS. You can use also ADS if you have no IoT infrastructure with a message broker. You can just connect to your machine via ADS. There's no magic. It will work in the same way. And then you see here all the different analyzes. So for tool 1, tool 2, tool 3. And of course, you can see also the reference scope now. And yeah, as expected, we have here now different charts. Can put them under each other again. And then we can do it also in this way, that we have all in a row. So there you see then tool 1, tool 2, tool 3. And you can take now the significant values, for example, the max temperature here of tool 1, and he jumps me to this position. Or you can see here the count on, for example, for tool 2. Then we have added here a new variable for you. And yeah, so you see them all here. And so the bar charts. And so it is related to your template, and this makes engineering really, really quick. You can think in machine modules, for example. Define a template for a machine module, or define a template for motion axis, for example, right? And there it gives also a special function. I like to describe this only because here that is very easy what we did now with just 2 inputs. But if you have multiple inputs, maybe a complete structure or something like that, if you take care on the names of the input, we check the match of the structured names with the names of the inputs here. So you can take a complete structure, put this here via drag drop, and then all the variables by just 1 drag drop operation will set automatically. And this makes them really quick. So if you think about motion axis, it could be possible that you have 20, 25, 30 or more axes in one application, right? And then this is very lovely and makes it easy. Okay, I hope you enjoyed our video tutorial and there were some useful information, especially in the usage of TwinCAT Analytics, a really powerful tool. I recommend you also all the other video tutorials, and I would say see you next time. Bye bye. Take care. All the best.